Hey guys, I just want to give a quick shout out to PLE Computers and Sennheiser for sponsoring us to go to QuakeCon 2017. Basically, the computers we use were really good for us being able to play at a super high level, and also the headphones that we used were at the event, which made us qualify for the top 32 Quake World Championships. Alright guys, enjoy the video. Hey guys, ZenAku here again with another video. Today we're going to be doing just a recap of the QuakeCon 2017 events. Basically just going through some of the things that happened and where I'll be going on in the future. So first off, we'll just talk about the boot camp that we had at the house in America, which was really good. We basically got to play against Dewey, Chance, Gelisak, and Spotty as well. And really those games are just more about just gaining the confidence of winning against those players. I think that we're actually like very similar skill, if not maybe a little bit better in some areas. And yeah, that was really good because I know Steej and I really just wanted to get in and get some games and just get some wins in versus them, just actually show that we can win versus them and there's nothing special about them. Next I'll talk about my that BYOC win versus Thumper. And yeah, that was really interesting because what happened was everyone had already qualified and we had just come from Australia. I'd played one series before, which was a bit easier, and then it was the game versus Thump 4. And I knew that, if I were to lose, that would be the end of that. And there were just thoughts running through my mind of, being the only Australian to not qualify if I had lost, and just the type of moves that I was playing. And it was interesting to see the effect that it really had on my play style. And yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, I still won the game, and I still think that Thumper is a good player. But yeah, I just wasn't really able to make, the traps or anything like that I normally do, because there was just, it's strange. I wasn't even thinking about the loss sometimes, but it was just more about what happened to my mind and how I wasn't even really thinking, like, what was even going on in the game sometimes. So yeah, at least I got that experience, and I just know how to, handle that a bit better. After that, we basically qualified for the group stage, where my group was Noctis, Dehang, and Scissor. So first up, I played Dehang, which was, those games were really nice. Basically, on both maps, I took the first round pretty convincingly. I would say, I played my game, and, things just really went my way, and it looked really strong every game. And then after that, that's when the trouble starts to happen. It was interesting, because almost every round went to sudden death, I think, because both Dehang and I were just playing so safely, and it would just basically be whoever made the first mistake, and that would be the end of it. I think we played Corruptor Keep and Blood Run, and, just some things that, I specifically remember a situation where I ran from Shotgun into Nail Gun Room when I had, both items, and I just tried to just make a move, and then I just get double direct rocketed when I'm moving at high speed, and it's just really fortunate for him. And I think that was the end of it, was round three or round four or something like that. But anyway, I get just more experience, and that'll have better results next time I play him. And then next I played Scissor, where I was able to play my games, and I think I won 2-0, which were really good. And then next I played Noctis, and this is where it gets really interesting, because I pretty much got destroyed by Noctis. And I would say the reason for that was, it was hard to understand, everyone plays Quake, there's, things you can do in Quake, but there's very subtleties that you can make changes to, and with a, CPMA player that really knows how to utilize Anarchy's movement, it was like very similar to how Claws was engaging into, certain rooms where you shoot a defensive rocket and it just won't do as much as it should versus every other player. So in your mind, you have you have a simulation of what you expect to happen. And then, I shoot a rocket when he's coming at me and it just does nothing. And I'm like, oh shit, I guess I'm pretty much dead here. And I think next time, for other international events, definitely going a bit earlier and just saying hey, let's play some games. And I think, the European guys are pretty friendly. They'll definitely, play us. And I'm not sure if Astro Boy really needs that kind of player in Python, but definitely for Steej and I, or even for me anyway, I definitely need that extra practice to really get the confidence, but understand how that works. And so that's just how that went down. Then just talking about really the grand final and how Claws played versus Vu. So, a couple things to note about that. Firstly, how European players use their LG. So I was actually sitting next to Claws in the group stage part of the bracket, and it was, everyone at that stage of the group stage has really excellent aim, but his aim was just like, yeah, I'll, like step above everybody else. He basically uses like a very low sensitivity with, relatively high acceleration, which means that, his LG is on point, and the way that he uses Railgun is pretty much, just to flick the mouse and then as soon as recalibrate, as soon as it's relatively close to them. But he was doing like really consistent flick rails, and his LG was just on point. And something to note about how the Europeans use their LG is they basically do this wiggle action. Now, the wiggle action is kind of the way I see it at the moment is if you're just using LG and you're using your brain to react to movements in game, you're not going to react fast enough, because what happened when but when you're doing the wiggle action, basically you just like wiggle your mouse onto the enemy character model, which is really effective for smaller base champions because of like the hitbox and how it's difficult to react to. But when you use the wiggle action, you're basically always on the champion's model even as they're moving. So, if you're using your brain to react, then by the time they've made a movement, you've basically lost 15% of damage. But if you're like constantly circling on the enemy model, even if they make the movement, you can kind of like, oh, he's you just like use your brain to readjust, but you're always doing just a little bit more damage. And the way that Claws played, he just basically utilized that really effectively and just like out LG'd a lot of people. I know Steej actually was able to do, really well versus Claws because his LG is like really, really good as well. And then something else to note about the grand final was, or just Claws' play in general, is how he engages in rooms and in fights. So, I guess first off, we'll talk about how he uses extremely risky plays, which in that particular environment is extremely, putting the pressure's on, and he obviously like is. I mean, he was invested, but he didn't. I don't know. He wasn't emotionally involved as Vu was, and he was able to, do crazy stuff like enter a room with Ghost Walk with 1 HP when he would have died by like one MG bullet, and Vu misses three rockets. Like, stuff like that is just ridiculous. And then also very similar to like how Noctis played, where, he'll enter a room, and he'll kind of sense where you are in the room. So let's say like you shoot a rocket, and it should do about like 60 damage versus Anarchy or something like that, and it does like 30, because he's like just kind of like constantly baiting your shot out, and then just moving in. And I've kind of thought about this idea as well, and I do it, but when he was playing, you could tell that, the amount of hours that he had simply put into Quake Champions, like he was able to just destroy anyone because he was just so hard to describe, but like in the zone for those type of movements, and it just looks like he just like destroyed people because, the fights would be so close with LG, and he'd just come out on top because again, he was doing like the wiggle action with LG, and then he would just take less damage, and so it would, in your mind, you kind of trick yourself because you think like, oh, this fight should I should win this, and then you lose, and he has like 30 HP left, and you're like, that's like really hard to deal with. Anyway, just more things about what's going to be happening in the future. Yeah, it's going to be the constant streaming, 7 to 10 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time most weeknights or any weeknights I'm available to do it. More videos about Quake Champions in general. I'm going to be doing one about just advanced ideas in Duel, like, well, I'll put it out later, and you'll see what it is like, and just yeah, future tournaments in Australia, and hopefully more international tournaments coming up. I know it's going to be a bit more difficult because I know FaZe and Camera are practicing, and they're obviously like really good players, which is good for me because there's going to be more competition in the scene, which means I can increase my game, but it's going to be harder to qualify, so I guess I'll have to deal with that. Anyway, guys, that's the end of the video. Thanks so much for watching, and yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.